With this year's budget meeting coming up on Monday night, some Milton residents are concerned over the increase of property taxes.
That's the most, like, we are concerned about it. Like someone talking about 7.8% and average 3.4, for example, some. So we don't want unreasonable increase in taxes.
But with the growing town's plans, an increase will be necessary to fund the costs.
It's basically a lot of people asking, you know, what are we getting for the increase? And basically it nets out to about 3.46, according to the town staff, between the region and the town education. What we're looking at for this year is basically moving ahead with a number of multi-year projects, such as the region with Britannia Road and Tremaine Road, and the town with such areas as Brawny Street, Louis St. Laurent, as well as, you know, park development.
Rural resident Betty Robertson would like a stronger fire department presence in the community.
We have a fire hall there, but it is not staffed full time. And we've had a couple of big fires recently. One of them where a horse barn burnt down, and I believe it was three horses died. And so it ended up taking 20 minutes to respond to that fire. And, you know, you always question whether or not if we had more staff, could we have gotten there earlier?
Bess says he, along with his fellow councillors, are reviewing core services in the town to see which departments need to be expanded on.
And basically reviewing the administration and what services can we deliver efficiently, because we're in that situation where Milton's too big to be small anymore. We can't do things we used to, but we're too small to be big. We're in that transition zone that we're not like some of the bigger cities around us that have whole departments. We have, in many cases, one or two people trying to deliver a service. And I'll give you an example. We had people criticizing our bylaw enforcement. We have 4.5 people in our whole bylaw enforcement department. And that's one thing we're looking at, it reviewing that and getting more proactive and having, you know, people out there rather than being reactive. And I'll be putting in some recommendations next one day or two.
Many issues residents shared their concerns were related to provincial and federal government legislation, such as two-way all-day GO Transit service, CN's proposed intermodal hub, and the Wilfrid Laurier University campus that was rescinded $90 million in funding from the Ontario government in October.
One more thing we are looking at in the future is dealing with the provincial government. We haven't heard from the new government exactly which way they want to go in terms of what transit, in terms of funding for the education village and other areas. So it's basically a lot of it's going to be wait and see this year. In 2020, with our new official plan, we'll know where we're going and start planning for the next 20 years. And we hope to have the education village back on track.
Any residents that weren't able to make the public information session can email the councillor at colin.best@milton.ca. Reporting from Milton, for Halton News, I'm Hayden Narine.